Hey everyone, thank you so much for tuning in. And yes, this is what you came for. Behold, the dragon fruit. This beautiful fruit comes in many different varieties. We have the yellow with the white flesh, the pink with the white flesh as well, and here we have the pink with the red flesh, otherwise known as the red dragon fruit. And it's actually in the cactus family, and there's another name for it called the pitahaya. So this fruit really reminds me of a kiwi. It has lots of little black seeds inside, hundreds of black seeds, and those seeds are actually really good for you. They contain omega-3 and omega-9, which is great fatty acids that really help reduce the LDL, or otherwise known as the bad cholesterol. So this is pretty much like a superfruit. Not one talent, but you gotta be no. Yeah, she fakes it till she makes it. So you just start off by chopping off the ends and splitting it in half and exposing the fleshy bits. And then once we have the skin off, we're just gonna go ahead and chop, chop, chop. Just get it on, got me feeling stagnant. Ooh, baby, I should be a barber. Look at that even cut. So even. And, you know, I had to get a little taste. I was like, what am I working with? That's pretty tasty. And then I was like, dang, this is so pigmented. The red dragon fruit is actually high in betalains, which is a bioactive compound that actually gives it that bright pink magenta color. And I mean, if you guys are gonna, you know, chop this fruit up, make sure you have a couple towels, some napkins laying around, because trust me, it's gonna get messy. And you just do the same thing with the second fruit. Chop off the ends, take off the skin, and get to slicing. So our dragon fruit is all chopped up. Perf! Then we take our bananas, which are full of vitamin B6, potassium, vitamin C, fiber, and antioxidants. Boom! So once we have our sliced bananas, we're gonna just add them to our bowl of dragon fruit. Just take the bananas and just sprinkle them ever so gingerly across the dragon fruit. It doesn't have to be pretty because it's going to look good in the end either way. I like my food to be pretty. I like pretty presentation, you know, because if it looks good, tastes good, right? Right? Yeah. Look how beauty. We're almost done. So next, I'm going to take my oatmeal and my cinnamon mixture and just sprinkle that on top of my fruit. And of course, you don't have to use oatmeal and cinnamon. You could use anything you'd like. Almonds, chocolate chips, raisins, flaxseed. You know, whatever floats your dragon fruit boat, man. Now I know what you're thinking. No, that is not poop. That's actually organic peanut butter mixed in with honey. It's very delicious. I completely lost the footage, but here it is. Voila. Try it out. It's a great mixture. And we're just going to continue with sprinkling our oats and cinnamon atop of the fruit. And we're almost done. Boom. There you have it. Our delicious dragon fruit banana bowl. Try out this recipe. You could, you know, add your own little tidbits to this recipe, or if you have any other recipes you want me to try and make a video, go ahead and let me know in the comments down below. And a quick shout out to my niece Krista, who I know is watching. I love you. Let me know in the comments down below if you've never tried dragon fruit, if you've tried it before, you loved it, you hated it. If you're gonna try this recipe, go ahead and share this video, give it a real big thumbs up. Peace. Thank you so much for watching, and be sure to check out my other videos. Later!